let's start from the atlas. Atlas is the first cervical vertebra, and the bone, the atlas, comprises of the larger neural ring. It has the larger neural ring and the two wings. Okay, these are the two wings, and the body is in the form of the thick plate. This body of the atlas is in the form of the thick plate only, and the wings, these wings of the atlas are the bony plates and projected on the either side of the neural ring. This is the neural ring, and the wings are projected on the either side of the neural ring. The supraspinous processes, as the supraspinous process as well as the ventral spine, are in the form of the tubercles. Okay, these are the supraspinous process and the ventral spine, as in the form of the tubercle. This is the ventral tubercle, and this is the dorsal tubercle. Okay, this is the ventral tubercle, this is the dorsal tubercle. On the cranial aspect, this is the cranial side, this is the caudal side, this is caudal and this is cranial. This is the this is dorsal view and this is ventral view. Okay, on the cranial aspect of the dorsal surface, this is the dorsal surface. This is the cranial view. Okay, there are the two foramina. Okay, the medial one is the intervertebral foramen. This is the intervertebral foramen, and the lateral one is the ulnar. Okay, ulnar foramen. Okay, ulnar foramen, and this is the intervertebral foramen, and both the foramina are lodged in the one depression. And the dorsal one is known as the ulnar foramen. Both the foramen are lodged in the one depression. The intervertebral foramen gives the passage to the first spinal nerve. The intervertebral foramen gives passage to the first spinal nerve. Okay, this gives passage to the first spinal nerve, and branch of the vertebral artery. And the ulnar foramen gives the passage of the dorsal branch of the first spinal nerve. The caudal to this depression. This is the caudal side. Okay, this is depression. This is the caudal side, and caudal to this depression, there are the two foramina. Okay, these are the two foramina, and caudal of the depression, there are the two foramina in the linear groove. This is the linear groove. At the caudal part of the flower, the neural ring, there is a depression called as the fovea dentis. This is the fovea dentis. Okay, there is the at the caudal part, there is a depression called as the fovea dentis, and this fovea dentis, which articulates with the odontoid process of the axis. The cranial aspect of the bone is highly concave. Okay, this cranial aspect of the bone is highly concave, to accommodate the occipital condyles. Okay, the cranial aspect is highly concave to accommodate the occipital condyles. These are the occipital condyles. Okay, and cranial aspect therefore is highly concave, and the caudal end bears the saddle shaped articular facets for the axis. This is the caudal end, and these are the two saddle shaped articular facet where the axis joins. Okay, the border of the wings are the convex. The border of the wings are the convex. These are the convex shaped wings. And the ventral surface of each wing is concave and termed as the fossa atlantis. Okay, this is the ventral surface, and ventral surface of each wing is concave and termed as the fossa atlantis. Okay, this term as the fossa atlantis. And the at fossa atlantis. On the dorsal side, there is the ulnar foramen, just near to this, intervertebral foramen is present. So this is about the atlas.